up on this edition of Inside the Tribe, let's take a look back at all the fun during homecoming week.
Plus, Kelsey and I are back with part two of Fast Food Frenzy. Inside this Tribe starts right now.
Joining us on this week's edition of Inside the Tribe. I'm Kelsey Griffin.
And I'm Alex Hinshaw.
Congratulations to the Marching Raiders for their performance at the Pontiac Marching Band competition on Saturday, September 18th. They won second overall in Class AA and best wins in their class.
Skills USA will be holding their first meeting on September 28th during Raider Hour. Skills USA is a partnership of students, teachers, and industry working together to ensure America has a skilled workforce. All those who signed up last year or are interested in learning more, please come see or email Mrs. Huff for a blue pass.
Do you want to join Best Buddies? Here are three ways to do so. Sign up online at bestbuddies.org/join, then find our East Peoria chapter, or join our Google Classroom. The code is BM56XTM. Or sign up on Remind. Text at bestbudEP to the number 81010.
Hope Club meets every Wednesday in 235B after school if you'd like to join.
A few college visits this week include September 28th, University of Tennessee Knoxville at 1:30, September 29th, Quincy University at 10, September 30th, Methodist College at 9:30, September 30th, Lincoln College at 2:30, and September 30th, St. Louis University at 2:30.
If you are still in need of a parking pass, you will need to see Officer Sargenti in the dean's office before or after school, or toward the end of the class with your teacher's permission. Passes are $30, cash or check. There are still a few students who paid online and have not picked them up yet. Parking enforcement has begun. Those without the current 2021-2022 parking pass risk a fine and/or their vehicle towed from either of our student lots.
Gavin G-Man Franklin is back with a look at this week's Raider weather.
Oh, biscuits. Sorry, guys. I was reading a good Divergent book here in the library, but I'm back, and I'm back with your weekly Raider weather report now. Monday will be a high of 86 degrees to a low of 59 degrees with sunny weather. Tuesday will be a high of 79 degrees to a low of 55 degrees with sunny weather. Wednesday will be a high of 73 degrees to a low of 52 degrees with sunny weather. Thursday will be a high of 72 degrees to a low of 55 degrees with cloudy weather. Friday will be a high of 72 degrees to a low of 54 degrees with cloudy weather. Saturday will be a high of 66 degrees to a low of 52 degrees with partly cloudy weather. And Sunday will be a high of 68 degrees to a low of 59 degrees with partly cloudy weather. So everybody, stay safe, stay strong, keep wearing your mask. Now will you excuse me, I gotta get back to my Divergent book. And a huge shout out to the librarians for having awesome books. See y'all later.
The girls' co-op swim team took first place in tri meet with Olympia and St. Thomas on Thursday, September 16th. Junior Kara Kaczynski participated in the meet and won both of her individual events, the 200 IM and the 100 fly.
Kara also participated in both the 200 free relay, which took second, and the 400 free relay, which took first.
Our second shout out also goes out to the girls' co-op swim team, who had a hard battle against Metamora on Tuesday, September 21st, but ultimately came out on top with a first place win.
Three EP swimmers participated in the meet. Junior Kara Kaczynski swam in two individual events. Junior Jillian Keller swam in two individual events. And freshman Kinley Keller swam in two individual events. Great job, ladies.
Coming up, Alex and I give you the rest of our review on which iced coffee is the best.
And we'll take a look back at homecoming week 2021.
Thank you. Next up is Zion's. We had such a beautiful picture what this drink looked like until I had to split it.
It was beautiful.
It was so mwah, so insert clip. It's called an ube latte. They said that the ube is kind of going to taste like, what did you say, cookies and cream?
Yeah, like cookies
so
and cream.
I'm which like it was really like purple. I'm so like,
it was so pretty.
I'm very excited.
I'm so excited. Okay, here we go.
Mmm, interesting. I can taste like a difference for sure, like the ube. I've never had ube before, but it just feels like a, it tastes kind of like something like a milk substitute would taste like. Like this isn't
like
milk in it.
I like it though.
Me too. That's really
and
interesting.
And it gives it like a little sweet like vibe.
Mm-hmm. It's like not too sweet for me. It's like a good amount of sweet,
yeah, it's definitely
but
more
I can
coffee.
Taste the coffee. And I can taste the flavor of the ube, which is cool. Also, I love the, like, big cubes
the big
of ice.
Ice cubes.
I don't know, they're just...
They're very, like, fun. Because not a lot of places have, like, the big ice cubes.
Yeah, it's different.
Also, their sizing.
Oh, yeah.
It's way bigger, especially their to-go cups. We got glass to take the beautiful picture because they said it was super pretty.
Mm-hmm.
So we just had to.
It was one of the most expensive.
Yeah, it was like kind of expensive.
Five and some change. But it's the biggest size we've had so far. And I'm liking it a lot.
I don't like this one as much. I just feel like this one would like definitely give me a stomach ache for some reason. Maybe that's also because we've already had like three coffees. But like my stomach is like...
It might not be... It's probably not sweet enough for you.
Mm-mm. It's not as good as Starbucks latte. I like that one a lot.
I don't know. I'm kind of liking it more than that. I rated the Starbucks a 6.5, but I think I'm honestly going to rate this one a 7.
Like, really?
It's not too sweet, and it, you can taste the coffee. I like the
you
ice.
You can taste the coffee.
And I like the flavor.
On, like, a, like, coffee, like, yes, like, if you want coffee, buy this. We'll say
7.5. 7.5? Okay. You know, I think 7. I'm kind of going to agree with you there on a 7.5. I very much enjoyed this one. Okay, so we went to Eli's next, and I'm really excited to try this one. They recommended a lot of stuff, but we went with the iced miel with almond milk, because that's what specifically the girl recommended. And
for translation, it's just iced coffee with honey and almond milk.
Yes, and cinnamon. But since this one has almond milk, it was like an upcharge of $1, so it was kind of like the most expensive one. It was like $5.77.
But if you take the almond milk out, it's not that expensive.
Yeah, it's like $4.77.
Yeah, or something like that.
Yes, so we're taking donations for the next video because this was expensive. Before we even try it, they were so sweet. They put a little note on it and it says, I hope you like it. The ladies were so
were
sweet. So
nice.
That's just like
best customer service
right
here. Best customer service.
Chick-fil-A service was good too, because
true.
I mean it's Chick-fil-A. But Zion was really nice too, but I don't know, this one was probably the best service. I mean, we got a cute little note.
Mmm.
Oh my gosh, that's really good. Mm. I can still taste the coffee. It's not too sweet, but it's just like there's still some sweetness. It's like just the right amount
with a little bit less cinnamon, because I think the cinnamon's a bit overpowering.
There is kind of a lot of cinnamon, but I like the. Let me try. I like the flavor. Like, I love almond milk, and I love the honey, and I can taste the coffee. This is really good.
I can taste all the flavors. Like, I can taste the honey, the almond milk, the cinnamon, the coffee.
Yeah.
But like, overall...
Probably the best flavor-wise, because...
I think this might be the... This might be
the
winner.
Did we save the best for the last?
Did we? Not even on purpose? And they have the best customer service, too.
This is so good. I'm, like, really enjoying it. I would 100% get this again. Oh my gosh, this is almost like a 10 out of 10.
10
or,
out
like,
of 10.
Maybe even 9.5, because there's, like... Maybe
too much
take
cinnamon.
A little less cinnamon,
yeah.
But
9.75.
There you go.
Out of 10.
This is really good. I gotta say, maybe it was worth it. How expensive it was.
Mm-hmm.
That was our final one.
Yeah.
So, in conclusion, drum roll, please. Eli's is the winner! Oh my goodness. We 10 out of 10. Okay, mm-hmm. 9.7 out of 10. Recommend Eli's, especially the iced meal with almond milk.
Yes.
No, I wasn't filming. That was just practice.
That we weren't?
No.
They say that life is a two-way street. When you're not sure, you gotta trust your feet to know the right way.
You can keep on moving with your head down, or you can stop and take a look around. And that's the choice I've made.
Yeah.
It's for that movie inside your head, making memories we can't forget. And when you can't forget, you're gonna know.
That's not all, but that's all we have time for today.
For the full set of announcements, be sure to go to the school's website, ep309.org.
Also, be sure to follow us on Instagram at @inside_the_tribe.
That's all for this week. Thanks for tuning in to this edition of Inside the Tribe. I'm Chelsea Griffin.
And I'm Alex Hinshaw. And from everyone here at Inside the Tribe,
have a great Raider Day.